Hey everyone, this is Jeff Bat with Learning Dojo, and welcome to this Storyline Quick Tip. I'm going to talk to you about adding a faded animation on hover and changing the states of this person when you hover over it. So keep in mind that this will not work on a mobile device. You could put this on a tap or a down state in order for it to work on a mobile device. But for now, we're just going to focus on the hover. So I'm going to go into the state section with this character selected, and I'm going to add a new state, and I'm going to select hover. Now this state will appear anytime I hover over this person. So I'm going to go ahead and click on add here. And with this person selected, I'm going to go into the design under this character tools, and I'm going to select the pose. We're going to change the pose of this person. So let's go ahead and change the pose of her just kind of with her arms out like that. That's great. So I'm going to go ahead and click on insert. And notice that the head and the feet kind of shift over from the original one. That to me is too much of a move there. So let's actually center her. I'm going to come into here and then move her over, and I'm going to try to get that head kind of positioned in the same spot. And you may have to eyeball it a little bit because this image is now wider than it was originally. So you can go back and forth. Looks like I need to move over a little bit more. Let's go like that. Oh, looks like I went too far. There we go. So now she doesn't shift very much there. Now let's go ahead and in the hover state, I'm going to go ahead and add a caption. Now this is going to be a little thought bubble or a speech bubble. And on the speech bubble, this little yellow square, you can position to where you want it to be coming from. Now under the format tool, let's go ahead and change the shape to kind of a gray shape here, or maybe even a white shape there. And in the outline, I'm going to go ahead and just get rid of the outline, and let's add just a slight drop shadow there, maybe just to have it pop out a little bit. I can adjust the drop shadow if I want to, but for now that's good. And I'm just going to say hello. Now on that, you can see that it has some type of drop shadow. I'm going to get rid of the drop shadow there. Just make sure that I select it, get rid of that drop shadow, and then let's change the font to kind of a black there. All right, so now with that selected, you could have this actually animate in. So with just that object selected, I'm going to go into the Animations tab, select Fade right there, and then now when this shows, it's going to fade in. So let's go ahead and preview this slide. All right, there's my person. So as soon as I hover over, you can see that that is going to fade in. Still a little bit of a jump on that person, but at least now we have that fade in. And I can even shorten it up a little bit. It's taking a little bit longer to have it fade in. So let me select that, and then I can change this down to like 0.5 seconds there. And that way it will go a little bit quicker. All right, so that's how you add an additional object to a hover state and how to have it fade in. Now, if you want to check out more, go to learningdojo.ninja. You can check out my blog. You can check out templates and then a full course on Articulate Storyline 360, as well as other courses on e-learning development. Thanks, everyone.